All right, what's going on, guys? Hope you're having a fantastic day. I got the van back here doing a whole bunch of mechanical work. Today, we're gonna be going over the EGR valve, which can cause a lot of problems in these sprinters. Huge pain in the butt, to be honest with you. But we're gonna go over cleaning it, we're gonna go over replacing it, and we're gonna go over bypassing it. When I picked this van up, it was having EGR problems. The owner told me all about them. I was all right with it, did a whole bunch of research. The EGR valves are always kind of causing issues. So I didn't think it was gonna be as bad as I thought, but when I was driving back, the van kept going into limp mode. And I brought my code reader, I kept deleting the codes that I was getting, and it just kept going into limp mode. I guess I should go over some of the symptoms of a bad EGR valve. So first of all, I guess your vehicle's gonna go into limp mode. You might not have an engine code, but you'll be pressing on that gas pedal and all of a sudden you're gonna have no power. The van's gonna be struggling to speed up, and you'll know right away. And a lot of people think, oh, my turbo's gone, or intake problem or something else, but chances are it's gonna be your EGR valve. So the next thing that gives it away is just billowing black smoke out of your exhaust. Like, that's what was happening to me too. And people are gonna hate you if they're driving behind you, but it's just one of the symptoms. The next one is an engine code. Now, there's a few different engine codes. I'm not exactly too sure what the numbers are, but oxygen sensor is one, EGR valve is one, and then turbo boost is another one. So there's three different codes. I think there's actually two different numbered codes for the EGR valve that came up for me. So this is the culprit right here. And this is the guy that we're gonna be removing, cleaning, and then replacing. I'll also show you how to bypass it. There's two different ways to bypass it. We'll go over both ways. One is by doing an engine tune, which is pretty expensive. And then the other one is inserting a little resistor inside the wiring harness, which is what I did. Works okay. This is the state of my EGR right now. Just check that over here. This is my wiring harness. I have the resistor taped in there. I used all this electrical tape just so water, dirt, grime didn't get stuck inside the harness after I bypassed it using this resistor. So I'll just show you what I did here and how you can also do this if you're interested in bypassing the EGR valve. Finding these resistors is a little tricky. You're probably gonna wanna go to a specialized electronics store because your normal auto parts store aren't gonna carry these. I had to look everywhere for them. I know you can buy them on Amazon, so that might be the best place. You can just order like 10 for $2 or something. They're super cheap. So if bypassing your EGR valve is something you're interested in doing, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your little resistor there and you're just gonna unplug the wire harness by pressing this little tab, which is gonna help you slide back the harness. And then you're gonna see three metal inserts there. And what you're gonna do is insert it into the middle one and the bottom one. It is a half watt, 2.2 ohm resistor. Notice the square top and then the rounded bevel edge on this end, and put it in those two slots. Get some electrical tape and just seal everything up. Make sure it's taped up really well, protected from grime and dust and anything, and water and anything else that can get in there. And then you're just gonna wanna tape it back up there. It's super easy to do. You'll still get an engine code, but it'll work, and it'll work for a long time, like as long as you wanna do that. We don't wanna do that because I don't want the engine light, and I like the full power. So I'm gonna remove that and gonna remove the EGR and clean it up. The other way to bypass the EGR valve is to get an engine tune. And there is a company out of California called GDE Tuning. They specialize in tuning. It's really popular for the sprinters. Tuning a diesel is one of the best things to do to get better fuel efficiency, more power. These engines have a lot of potential, and usually it's not all used in the factory. So getting one of these tunes is a good idea. think they're about $600 American. So we looked into getting it right now, decided just to replace that EGR valve, see how things go. But in the future, I would love to get one of those tunes. I'll put a link in the description to the website where you can get those tunes. Be sure to check out your local emissions codes before you do that, because like I said before, some countries require certain emission standards, and that tune won't qualify for some of them. So yeah, be sure to look into that before you do it. Number one, when removing your EGR valve, is there are three bolts that you're gonna wanna undo. So one is right here, the other one's right there, and then another bolt right on the bottom there. There is also this coolant hose that you're gonna wanna just get a flathead screwdriver and loosen up that clamp right there, and then you'll just be able to slide that off. The other thing is just the harness that you just take off by pressing this tab in on the end here and just sliding it back. Comes off pretty easy. Take a flathead screwdriver, just loosen up this clamp that holds the coolant line onto the side of the EGR valve. This is one thing you're gonna wanna do it when the engine's cold, because you don't want hot coolant flying everywhere and burning yourself. So best to let the engine cool down. Next thing, just give it a little rotate, and now coolant is gonna come out when I loosen this off, but just try to a little mess as possible. Try and tuck that back up so you don't have a ton of coolant going everywhere. All right, and then next step, you're gonna wanna grab 8mm socket, loosen up these bolts. These bolts are pretty long too, so take those out, put those off to the side so you don't lose them. And then give her a little wiggle, out she comes. And then you also have a gasket that sits on top right there that you're gonna wanna remove and take out. So that is what it looks like after everything removed. So we're gonna go ahead and going to grab some carb cleaner and a wire brush and give that a good scrub, get it nice and clean. And then also same to this old EGR valve right here. Okay, so this is my old EGR valve, obviously completely dirty. This is why it's not functioning properly. So when you move that propeller there, it's supposed to snap back into place, and that is not snapping back at all. So these can get really coated with soot. So you're gonna wanna get some carb cleaner and a nice little wire brush. Scrub, 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 scrub the inside. Get it as clean as you can. Anyways, I'm gonna show you what a new one looks like and how it should function. So this is a brand new one. Try to get yours as clean as this, and you should be good to go as long as that spring's working well. But so this prop is supposed to open all the way and snap close, just like that, nice and crisp. This is a brand new one. I got on eBay for $250. I'm not too sure if it's gonna work or not, but hoping so. It seems to be decently well built, but we'll put it to the test and see how long it lasts. So while I'm just cleaning the inside of this exhaust valve, I might as well explain to you what the EGR valve does. So the EGR stands for exhaust gas recirculation, and that's exactly what the valve does. So it basically takes your old exhaust fumes and recirculates them. It's better for emissions, better for the environment. A lot of countries have codes for what your emissions have to be roadworthy. We don't here in Canada, so that's why a lot of people bypass them, but there's a lot of places like California. I know over in Europe, they can be pretty strict on emissions as well, so you have to have one of these. They've gone even further now, like all the new sprinters have DPFs and all that complicated stuff on their exhaust. But yeah, that's what this valve does. That's why it's important. That's why you might need it to pass an inspection to get your vehicle insured. So I've got this surface cleaned up decently well, just carb cleaner, wire brush, cut inside too. Looks pretty good. Just grab a gasket right there. That is just going to fit like so. And then grab your new EGR valve or cleaned EGR valve, whichever seems to be working, and that's totally the wrong way. And then you're just gonna wanna slide it right in. And then you can grab your bolts. Turn them in by hand. Socket. Now I'm not too sure what the proper foot pounds is for these, but I usually just go on something like this. I'll just go snug. And test it out, keep an eye on it, make sure nothing's like leaking or seeping out. I wouldn't imagine, you really don't want to over tighten bolts like this because they're pretty small. And this receives a ton of heat. So yeah, you definitely don't want to over tighten them because then you'll snap them off, can't get them out, be a brutal battle. All right, and then you want to take your coolant line, stick that sucker back on, clamp, screwdriver, tighten that back up. And then grab your wiring harness, slip that guy back on there. Make sure your wire is not rubbing on anything or bouncing off. I might have to move that clamp around, but let's see, so should we go? Good to go. And then if you have any codes, obviously you're gonna wanna delete those or get somebody to delete them. All right, so last thing you're gonna wanna do after you got that EGR valve installed is top up the coolant a little bit. A little bit comes out when you disconnect that hose, but not enough to be really concerned about, but you are going to want to top it up a little bit just to replace the stuff you lost. If you have questions regarding the EGR valve, be sure to leave them below. I know I searched through a whole bunch of content online and couldn't find anything all that great when we were having problems with it. So hope this video helped you either clean or bypass the EGR valve or replace it like I did. If you like this video, make sure to give it a like, subscribe, and hit that bell to be notified because me and Kaylee are gonna be posting a new video every week. I know Kaylee's not here, but she's not huge into the mechanical stuff. She's actually been doing a lot of work inside though, taping out everything, getting the bed, all the kitchen stuff laid out. So it's looking pretty good. We're actually just working on the roof stuff too. So skylights, fan, those pot lights, oh, it's gonna be looking so good. One more thing, got the brakes in today, so I'm gonna be doing a complete brake job on this vehicle. Front brakes, front rotors, front pads, rear rotors, rear pads, and rear shoes. So I'm gonna be doing the parking brake as well. If you have any questions regarding that, head over, check out that video. It's gonna be a good one. Also gonna be redoing the stereo inside, so got a nice brand new one, touchscreen. Oh, it's gonna be good. Be sure to check that one out too. All right, see you in the next one.